So today I wanted to set up my Louis Vuitton GM agenda on camera with you guys. A lot of people ask me how I set up my planner, what's my thought process, and they really want to see it kind of simplified. I know it can seem a little bit daunting, but I'm just going to show you guys how I set mine up. There's a lot of thought and preparation that goes into creating a planner setup like this, but it's not that hard. You just need to do a little bit of research, and the best way to do that is on Instagram, searching hashtags, shops, stuff like that. So I'm just going to get into it. I have just a bunch of inserts. So basically, all I'm really going to be using are the inserts, the planner, and then some of these accessories. I've got a dashboard, a flyleaf, a ruler, and then just some dividers, and these are all from cloth and paper besides the file effects ruler. So I've put in everything that I want to kind of outline my planner, and as I start using it, I'll probably start adding more inserts of certain kinds that I find that I like more. I'll show you guys the weekly inserts that I have in here now. I have a few different styles, but it usually takes me a week or two to kind of adapt to my new planner system and decide what's working for me and what's not. So I just added a couple of decorations up here in the front because I thought they'd be really nice to look at. I just have this little Burberry card that came with my other Burberry planner. And then this is from cloth and paper from one of the stationery boxes. And then I just have some minimal stickers and an Ollie clip. I always like to have an Ollie clip in my planner just in case. I love this dashboard from cloth and paper. I'll have it linked below. I don't know if there's any left, but this came in, I believe this came in the February stationery box, and I just love it. And since it's one of my initials, I just really like to have that when I open up. And then right after that, I have a flyleaf just to stick any sticky notes on. And then I have this dashboard from Ellenmon Paper Co., and I love it. And I just printed it and I stuck some sticky notes on top. So this is kind of like the first thing I see when I enter my actual planning system. And then in my schedule section, I have an inbox. So this is a dashboard that came in one of the cloth and paper stationery boxes. You're probably going to see a lot of stuff that came in their stationery boxes. It's a really good way to just kind of keep adding to your collection. So, I have this right in the front, and then I have just a notes page to do my inbox on. Immediately following that, I have the month on one page overviews from 8 Lotus. I really love this layout. I might use this in my financial section down the road, but for now I like it in the very front. After that, I have my daily plan. I just like to have some dailies at the front of my page. These are undated, so I can just use these when I need them. My list section is actually holding like this second half to my schedule. So this has my month on two page from 8 Lotus. I just really like the layout. I love the space. After that, I have my weekly inserts from 8 Lotus. These have a week on one page, horizontal layout, and then on the following page, there's memo, priorities, expenses, to do, and next week. Following that, I have my Hobonichi weekly inserts from cloth and paper, and these are also from the stationery box, but these are now available on the cloth and paper website, so you can pick these up now. But I really love this layout. It's a week on one page, and then it has grid, and I've been doing a lot of planning in these the past couple weeks. I really, really like it. I feel like I have so much room to just brain dump and plan out just like ideas and things like that. So I really like these. And then after that, I have the cloth and paper hourly weekly inserts. Really, really like them. I just used them for this week. It's a vertical weekly timed layout, which has 6 a.m. to 11 p.m. and then Saturday and Sunday are split. That's a pretty typical layout that you might see in any type of insert shop. I just love these. I love the fonts, and I love just the aesthetic of it too, so I really love these. And then the back half of my planner is still a work in progress, but I do have some things in my project section. I just have another dashboard from Elmont Paper Co., and I love this dashboard. It has my initials on it, and I usually stick sticky notes on here, so that's what I'll be using this for. Then I just have a notes page in here now, and then I'm probably going to grab some project inserts for this as well. My next section is finance, and right now I just have purchases. I just want to keep track of like online orders, but I also want to add a section for my budget, and I'm thinking I might do an income sheet on here, so I'm still kind of deciding how I want to do that, but I will definitely be adding some more to this section. Then for goals and ideas, I don't think I'm going to use this for goals and ideas. I think I'm going to use this for like personal projects or other personal information that I want to keep in my planner. Then I have nothing behind the miscellaneous. I like to keep this back dashboard as kind of a page lifter. And then I've been keeping this in here, and it just has some information I need to hold on to. I just kind of slide it back here and it stays in pretty nice. But so far, I'm really, really excited about this planner. I hope this was semi-helpful for you guys to see how easy it can be to set up a planner like this. All it is just picking the planner that works for you, the size that you want, and finding inserts and finding things that are really going to help you be productive. So I hope this was helpful. If you have questions, let me know, like I said. But thank you guys so much for watching. I will be updating you pretty soon here as I start using these inserts a little bit more and deciding what works for me and what doesn't. But I'm going to go, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!